Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, Breaking the Barriers. So today we are going to cover a prose from class 10th CBSE English syllabus, that is Glimpse of India. Yes, you heard it right. This particular chapter is divided into three parts. Part 1, A Baker from Goa. Part 2, Coorg. And part 3, Tea from Assam. Now, what this chapter is, it's a mixture of three different culture which are there in our country, India. This chapter shows you, or as the name suggests, give you a glimpse, ek jhalak deta hai, of the diversity of India, how diversified Indian country and the region is. So, we will cover all the three parts in this video. I will give you an intro, vocab and summary of all the three parts. After watching with this video, you will be able to understand this chapter in a very effective way when you will read it from your NCERT book. So, if you like my channel, please subscribe it. If you like the video, please do not forget to hit the like button after you watch the video and share my channel and promote the content, which will help me and motivate me to make more such videos for you all. So without wasting any time, let's begin. So follow the cursor on the screen. Glimpse of India, Baker from Goa, Part 1 by Lucio Rodrigues. The interesting thing is that all the three parts are written by different writers. Okay, so Part 1 is A Baker from Goa. Now Goa in the past years, if we talk about 200, 300 years ago, Goa was a region of India which was inhabited by the Portuguese people. So we will see that what is there related to these Portuguese people and their culture in Goa in this first part. A Baker from Goa revolves around the relevance of a baker in the Goan culture, which dates back to the time when Portuguese ruled over the city of the Goa. So baker culture, we all know who's a baker. Baker is a man who has a bakery and bakes various items like cake, breads, bread loaves and patties, etc. All the bakery item, buns. So this baker was a very important part of the Goan culture when it was ruled by the Portuguese people. The Portuguese may have left, but the bread makers continue to have an inevitable stature. Means the status of the bread makers is still the same as it was in the Portuguese era. In this story, the author recalls his childhood days and their excitement on seeing a baker. The author is saying that how excited we used to be when a baker used to visit the town. That excitement he has shared in this chapter. They were enthusiastic to the point that they would run to him as soon as they woke up without even brushing their teeth. Now, in those time, according to this chapter, baker used to come like a hawker. Saman bechne wale jaise gali gali aate hain, usi tarah baker used to come and baker used to set up his stand on a bamboo with a basket and he used to sell the bread. Means baker don't used to do the business from the shop, they used to come like hawkers. Okay, so we'll see what is there in the chapter. Second sheet is the vocabulary sheet. I want you to pause the video and note down this vocabulary sheet in your notebook. It has all the difficult words which will be there in first part, The Baker from Goa. And if you know the meaning of these words, it will help you to understand the chapter in a better way. Let's move ahead. This is the summary of part 1, Baker from Goa. So we'll discuss this summary. The lesson begins with how narrator's elders often recall the time when Goa was under the rule of the Portuguese. They talk how the importance of bakers is still maintained in their village even after the Portuguese have left. So from the elders, author and other people of that particular region got to know about the Portuguese culture and the culture where baker was given very much importance. They were known as padders in Goa. Okay, so in those days they were known as padders. The mixers who used to mix the batter, the molders who used to mold the batter into various shapes and sizes. अकॉर्डिंग टू द डिमांड एंड देयर टाइम टेस्टेड फर्नेसेस. फर्नेस मीन्स भट्टी, जिसमें बेकर्स जो होते हैं वो ब्रेड या बंस वगैरह को सेकते हैं. गुड कंटिन्यू टू सर्व द पीपल ऑफ गोवा विद देयर फेमस ब्रेड लोव्स. इट इज पॉसिबल दैट द ओरिजिनल वंस मे नॉट एग्जिस्ट बट देयर प्रोफेशन इज नॉट बीइंग कंटिन्यूड बाय देयर सन. सो द ओरिजिनल बेकर्स हैव डाइड बट देयर सन्स हैव कंटिन्यूड द प्रोफेशन. द थड ऑफ देयर बैम्बू स्टिक कैन स्टिल बी हर्ड इन सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द विलेज. नाउ दे यूज्ड टू हैव अ बैम्बू स्टिक, अ स्टैंड विच इज मेड अप ऑफ बैम्बू स्टिक एंड दे यूज्ड टू bring that stand and the basket. Basket used to be on their head and stand on the next side to the shoulder, and they used to come, they used to put the stand and then used to place the basket on top of the stand. Like you must have seen some peddlers or hawkers on the street doing the same thing. The same jingling thud would wake the narrator and his friend during their childhood days, who would go running to him without brushing or washing their mouth properly. The jingling means the sound of the bamboo. It was the maid servant of the house who collected the loaves while children sorted out the bread bangles for themselves. So all the maids of the house used to come out and they used to collect the loaves for the dinner, the snacks and all. And the children used to come for their bread bangles. Bread bangles were kind of sweet breads which were enjoyed by the children. Bakery products are important in the culture and tradition of Goa. Bhol is a sweet bread which is a part of marriage gifts. Cakes and bolinas or coconut cookies are eaten at every festival, and ladies of the house prepare sandwiches at the daughter's engagement. So all these functions cannot be conducted without the bread. Earlier bakers wore a unique frock of knee length known as kabai, but during the narrator's childhood days they wore a shirt and trouser of length slightly shorter than the usual ones. So previously bakers used to wear a knee length frock, घुटने तक की एक फ्रॉक होती थी, it was known as kabai, but later on they started wearing pant and trouser. Generally collected their bills at the end of the month. Bakery has continued to be a profitable profession, managing to keep their families joyous and prosperous. So this is the summary of part 1. Now let's move to the next part. Glimpse of India Part 2 Coorg by Lokesh Abril. What is the introduction? The lesson gives us a beautiful insight of the smallest district of Karnataka and its people. The place has amazing weather throughout the year with enough rain during the monsoon season. People of Coorg are known to be one of the bravest, and coffee is the main crop grown in the region. Variety of animals are found in this place, surrounded by the beautiful Brahmagiri Hills, islands and Tibetan settlement. So this gives you a idea of what Coorg is. It's a small district of Karnataka. Let's see what's there in this chapter. The vocab sheet. Now this vocab is divided into two slides, 11 words in the beginning and then the remaining in the second slide. I want you all to again pause the video and copy these word meanings in your notebook. This is the first slide, number 1 to 11, and then we have the second. After that we come to the summary. The writer describes the hill station of Coorg located in the Western Ghats in the state of Karnataka. It is located midway between Bangalore and Mangalore. The suitable time to visit Coorg is from September to March. Place is famous for coffee plantation and spices. There are abundant rainforests which cover 30% of the area. Very good. Coorgi men are brave warriors who are permitted to keep firearms without a license due to their trustworthiness. Okay, throughout the India, if you want to carry some firearms like guns and all, you need to first have a license for that. But the Coorgi people are exempted from this rule. That means they can carry firearms without license. This is the freedom given to them by the Indian government. Women of Coorg are pretty. Coorg is also known as Kodavu, and the Kodavus, though are Hindus by religion, but their customs differ from those of the mainstream Hindus. The major population of Coorg is Hindu, but the custom and tradition they follow are different from the mainstream Hindus. They marry within their community. Kodavus are said to be the Greek or Arabic descent. Okay, they are originally of Arabic descent, means they are Arab ke rehne wale the, unke ancestors. some soldiers. Now, what's the story behind this? Arab se kaise aaye? Some soldiers of Alexander's army settled there. Also, as the ethnic dress of the Kodavus, kufia, is similar to the Arab garment, kufia. It is said that maybe their ancestors were Arabs or Turks. So, Alexander की आर्मी के कुछ सोल्जर्स थे जो आए, और जब वापस जाना पॉसिबल नहीं रहा तो वो यहीं पर सेटल हो गए. और इनकी एक ड्रेस है कूपिया, जो अरब गारमेंट कोफिया से सिमिलर है. दैट इज ऑल्सो रीजन वाई इट इज अज्यूम दैट दे आर फ्रॉम अरब डिसेंट. द रिवर कावेरी ओरिजिनेट्स फ्रॉम कूर्ग. द फिश नेम्ड महासीर इज फाउंड इन द रिवर. मेनी एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स लाइक किंगफिशर, लंगूर, स्क्वेरल, एलिफेंट्स कैन बी स्पॉटेड अलोंग द रिवर. टूरिस्ट रिलैक्स इन द सीरीन एटमोसफियर एंड ऑल्सो एंजॉय एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट्स लाइक रिवर राफ्टिंग, कैनोइंग, रेपलिंग, माउंटेन बाइकिंग, रॉक क्लाइंबिंग एंड ट्रेकिंग. ऑल दीज स्पोर्ट्स आर अवेलेबल देयर. वाइल्ड ट्रेकिंग ऑन द नेचुरल ट्रेल्स, एनिमल्स लाइक मकाऊ, मलाबार स्क्विरल्स, लंगूर, स्लेंडर लॉरिस कैन बी स्पॉटेड ऑन द ट्रीज. मेजर टूरिस्ट अट्रैक्शंस आर ब्रह्मगिरी हिल्स, निसारगम आइलैंड एंड बायलाकुप्पे तिब्बत सेटलमेंट्स. Coorg gives visitors a feel of Indian diversified natures. So this is the explanation of second part. Now we come to the third. So this is the third part, Glimpse of India, Tea from Assam, Part 3 by Arup Kumar Datta. Now what is this? The introduction. Lesson is a story of two friends, Pranjal and Rajveer, who are traveling to Pranjal's hometown Assam for the summer vacations. Assam is known as the tea country. It has largest concentration of plantations in the world. Biggest tea producer of the world. During their journey, they discuss about the various legends that are known to have discovered tea. The story tells us about the popularity of tea as a beverage. So, a story about tea. This is the vocabulary sheet. From 1 to 18, it has 18 words. And I want you again to pause the video and note down this vocab in your notebook. Now, let's come to the explanation part. So, this is the summary of the third part. Let's see. The story revolves around the infamous beverage tea, telling us more about its history and discovery, how tea was discovered. It begins from the scene where two friends, Pranjal and Rajveer, are set to go to Assam, Pranjal's hometown, where a tea vendor asks them if they would like to have some freshly made tea. They buy two cups, joining almost every other person in the compartment. So two friends, Pranjal and Rajveen, are going to Assam, which is Pranjal's hometown. And they are in their train journey. And on the way, they are drinking tea in the compartment of the train with the other people. And Pranjal starts reading a detective book while Rajveer decides to enjoy the scenic beauty. The green, soft paddy fields followed by tea bushes. Rajveer is very excited on seeing large tea plantations. But Pranjal is unable to match the same level because he was born and brought up in Assam, which is famously known as the tea country. Now, Rajveer is very excited because he is going to that particular town for the first time. But Pranjal is not that excited because according to him, there is nothing new because he was born and brought up in the same area. And that is why there is nothing new for him. Visiting there for the first time, Rajveer did a lot of study about how tea was discovered and that it dates back to 2700 BC according to what he read. It was first consumed in China and reached Europe in the 16th century, where it was mostly popular for its medicinal properties. So Rajveer has done a lot of research on the tea before visiting Assam, and he's saying that tea was first discovered in China and then later on in Europe in the 16th century, where it was consumed for its medicinal properties. Numerous of stories about the tea, like the story of the Chinese emperor and the Buddhist monk. The Chinese emperor liked the taste of the tea, and the Buddhist monk used to drink it to get rid of sleep. As they were having this discussion, they reached their destination where Pranjal's parents have come to receive them and take them to their tea garden. On their way, they passed a cattle bridge and gave way to a truck filled with tea leaves, which drew their attention to the fact that it was the second sprouting season. So Pranjal's parents came and they received the two boys and they are taking them to the tea garden. On their way, they found a cattle bridge and a truck which is filled with tea leaves, which shows them that the sprouting season matlab nayi pattiyan nikalne ka season hai. That is why wo truck mein pattiyan ja rahi hai to the factory, jahan wo process hoke tea banega un leaves se. Rajveer indeed did a lot of study before coming, which impresses Pranjal's father. and he is intended to learn a lot more. So this finishes the summary of the third part. तीनों पार्ट के हम लोगों ने समरी डिस्कस कर ली, वोकैब डिस्कस कर लिया, इंट्रोडक्शन डिस्कस कर लिया. आफ्टर वॉचिंग द वीडियो यू रीड द चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर एनसीईआरटी बुक एंड यू विल डेफिनेटली अंडरस्टैंड द चैप्टर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन मेंशन देम इन द कमेंट सेक्शन एंड आई विल आंसर देम. लाइक द वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब द चैनल, कीप प्रमोटिंग. बाय बाय, हैप्पी लर्निंग.